The Monetary Policy Committee recently came out with its recommendations, and we had the briefing by the RBI to put give further light to this. We have an expert panel from FICCI. May I invite Ms. Nandana Kidwai to begin with her comments.
Well, I have to say that RBI has gone beyond expectations. There are three clear directions set by RBI, which are extremely laudable. One, that the growth objective is right on top. The second is that there is a lid on risk-free rates, which is important as we look at that growth. And the third is that there is an encouraging of banks to lend more, all of which will help get the economy off from the green shoots that are beginning to show. I would just say that the 9.5% GDP contraction as per FY21 projected by RBI, in my mind, is a bit optimistic. I think FICCI too will look at these numbers. We can hope it'll be 9.5%, but the street still looks like 10 to 12%, and we will have to see where the economy finally ends. But the good news is it is all improving. On the co-lending, again, encouraging and increasing the limits for NBFCs and HFCs is extremely important. We have to push on the execution because one of the issues remains that banks and NBFCs, in terms of the way they look at risk, is somewhat different. And aligning that so that this can move forward will be important.
It was very welcome to see that the Monetary Policy Committee was unanimous in its decision to keep the rates intact. And in fact, the policy guidance is unambiguous and very clear that I think throughout this financial year, we are going to see softer rates. The inflation phenomenon is believed to be transient. So in fact, we can expect actual rate action later this year or early next year. And the liquidity, let's say the targeted LTRO extension on as if on tap, or the support for state government bonds in terms of OMOs. All this will go towards not only keeping the borrowing costs low, but also to ensure that the transmission of the lower rates will happen. So I think all in all, a very welcome and supportive monetary policy to help the fiscal action that is expected.
Economic Committee at FICCI has deliberated on the various scenarios. And I think overall, in the backdrop of the recently announced September numbers, with the growing GST collection, which was indeed very positive, with the other indices also looking up, I think we are very happy to see the current RBI monetary policy announcements. And given the evolving growth inflation dynamic, there was clearly a need to have a focus on reviving growth. And we're happy to see the MPC signaling that it's going to support measures to energize growth. And while the policy repo rate was not cut by RBI, several of the measures were announced which will help bring down interest rates in the market, as my colleagues have mentioned. Various other initiatives are all signaling towards a revival of the economy and a positive next few quarters. I also want to specifically call out the fact that the decision to discontinue the automatic caution listing will benefit exporters. And FICCI had on several occasions brought this issue up with RBI, and we're very happy to see this positive mood, as well as the response of RBI to many other suggestions made by FICCI. We believe that the RBI, the government, the industry, and society at large are all working positively together for strengthening the economy and for a brighter outlook for our country at large.